Astrology Soulmates, and welcome to your weekly horoscope for the week of July 27th, where this week it's interesting because there's kind of an oppositional feel to the week. What am I really doing? Where are my boundaries? How far do I push? Do I need to adjust this? So it's going to be an interesting week, and I'm going to tell you about everything that I see coming up for you. But before we jump into the week, I want to do a little housekeeping here. First of all, there are some solstice gifts left over, so you can definitely check them out. Everything will be in the description box down below. But also coming up just Monday here on the channel, we're welcoming over Chris Brennan to the Eat and Greets, and he's going to be talking to us about the timing technique of perfections. So if you've not ever studied your perfections, if you don't know what they're about, or if you just want to learn more about it and learn more about how Chris Brennan does astrology, Hellenistic is his vibe. So if that's what you're interested in, you're going to definitely want to come to the Eat and Greet on Monday and check it out. As well as we push ourselves and we get more into the energy of August. August 7th through the 9th, I'm going to be a part of this beautiful astrological summit of purpose and passion, and I hope that you will absolutely join. The summit itself to attend is absolutely free. There's 17 different astrologers, from some people who've been in the game from a long time to up-and-comers who are a part of this community, and we're all showing up, getting together, giving you the empowering aspects of astrology and how to use them. So if you want to come, it's absolutely free. I will put the registration link in the description box down below. Now, if you know you want access to all those talks afterwards, it's $47 if you sign up early, or you can do it later and it's $97. Either way, the link's in the description box down below. I can't wait to show up, be a part of teaching with these beautiful other women and giving some empowering astrological tips to our community. So make sure you check all of that out, okay? All right, on to the week. What have we got going on here? Now, first of all, we are leaving July and we're coming into the energy of August. So we are making just a month shift. And sometimes that brings a different vibe with it in and of itself. But I can tell you, as we're coming into this week and we're coming in with the moon in the energy of Scorpio, not this heavy, scary, oh my God, it's Scorpio kind of energy, but it's more of, we need to think deep. We need to think in more of a melding, intense kind of way, and our insides may be set in that direction as we come into the week as well. And that can also lead to a small sense of uncertainty. Not to mention, we've got Mercury, our planet of the mind, coming into two different oppositions this week that I think are very powerful for us to explore. And we will also see the Sun and Uranus coming together, okay? So Mercury starts this week coming in opposition to Jupiter. Now, these are two planets of the mind. Mercury wants the small details, the analytics. Jupiter wants the big picture. Now, these two being in opposition to each other, they're going in two different directions, meaning that Jupiter, even though he's in the energy of Capricorn, Jupiter still does want to be bigger. There is an optimism and an expansiveness that comes with Jupiter's energy in this particular placement. And it is also the place where, in opposition to Mercury, who also governs our communication, you could find yourself making something bigger than it needs to be. You know, you make a mountain out of a molehill with something this week, or you're trying to negotiate something, or somebody's trying to sell you something and they're just overdoing it. Like, the embellishment is so real. So you want to be mindful of those energies as you're navigating this week. And it's not that good things are not available under this, but it is simply, you want to be clear on what the facts are, and that's hard in an opposition. Now, in my practice, I also tend to find that oppositions are relational. So you may very well be talking to another person, not just another entity or another company, but another person. And it's like, well, hold on, this seems really big. This seems really delicious. This seems really whatever. And it's a little bit bigger than maybe it needs to be. Now, on that same day, we're going to see Mercury and Neptune coming into a trine together, all in the same day on the 30th. Okay. So this again, this is this energy of in between the worlds. Now, the trine is an aspect of ease, but sometimes the ease between Neptune and Mercury can be in this position where it's like, oh, well, it seems vague, right? Like, there's an easiness for having vague information come to the table. So truly this week, I'm going to tell you, make a list and check it twice, just like Santa. Make sure you go over that thing for the clarity of facts. Now, where do you use that and celebrate the heck out of it this week? It is so good for being creative, but it is also an absolutely beautiful energy for creating opportunities for yourself. Take advantage of that Jupiter opposition. Somebody may be telling you, hey, there's a pocket of or a niche that is open and available to you, and then you can take advantage of it as we get towards next week. Leave this week for the details and gather the information for what you can do next week with something creative. Maybe even a big opportunity becomes on your radar this week. So don't fear it. Just understand we want the details, okay? Now, we've got Mercury and Pluto, our planet of transformation, evolution, death, and rebirth, coming into opposition with one another on Saturday, August 1st. This is just bringing us right into August. Let's come on in with some Pluto influence, right? Now, this is an interesting opposition. Because what it gives me the sense is on one side, maybe there is not only not clarity of information, but there's control. Like you're fighting over control of something, or you're feeling pulled in two different directions of control. And it's like, hold on, I've just had this Mercury Neptune. What do I let go of? Mars is in his home sign of Aries. Maybe you're feeling like you have to fight harder, longer, bigger, stronger for something than you need to. Again, ground down to the best of your ability into your facts this week. What are the facts? Is this actually still serving you, right? Does this fit on your radar? Is this something that does deserve your fight and your attention? And is it something that you're fighting too hard? Especially look at your relationships. Look at your home life this week. Is there something that you're fighting to maintain control of that is actually trying to turn into something else? And the last thing I think I want to bring your attention to this week with that Pluto is that while you're considering all of these things, we take time to meditate, to sit, to be with information, to not have to be so impulsive. But look at where you're sitting and you've taken your eye off the prize and you're sitting and your meditation has actually turned into a form of manipulation, or it's actually turned into a form of procrastination, right? Meditation in and of itself is a practice that should be blistering and should empower you. But at some point, we can sometimes shift that into the wrong focus. So look at what that's actually doing and producing in your life as well. Okay. Now, it does come to my attention too. I'm pointing out for some of you, pay attention to the people you're dealing with this week, and make sure you're dealing with people who are not trying to come into a position of dominance with you, or you're not coming into a position with somebody who is convincing you to do something that you're not really long-term going to be interested in, okay? Now, as we're coming to the end of this week, we see the Sun and Uranus coming together in a square, and this is going to bring us to Sunday, August 2nd. Now, a Sun-Uranus square, I actually like this because the square says move, take action. We need to do something here. We're under pressure. We're under tension. But Uranus square the Sun can be restlessness. It's full restlessness. I feel like I need to be doing something. This needs to be different, right? Now, what you don't want to do is just go blow up the bridge because you're feeling restless. But instead, enjoy your unpredictable behavior. Enjoy your unpredictable thoughts. What's coming up for you? Maybe it's something that is forcing you out of your normal box and your normal rut into thinking, moving, action, and being courageous about something else. The Sun is beaming in the energy of Leo. Now, as it connects with this Uranian energy, what is it showing you about your own bravery, about your own expression? Now, on the other side of that as well, sometimes what we can see with this is that other people around us, this hits them in a different way. So they really have some erratic, unpredictable behavior. Mars is still again in his home sign, and this could lead to a little bit of conflict. So, you know, what are you fighting for? Just be mindful of what you are fighting for. That's what I'll tell you this week. Look at the facts, be mindful of what you're fighting for, and then you can take these shifts and these timings that actually are creating some really nice movement of energy for you to do something really productive with it. Now, the other thing I just want to say too, because Uranus is over there in the energy of Taurus, and this is coming into square with that Sun in Leo, some of you might really be feeling the push to be working out or to be changing your diets up in some way, shape, or form. As long as you don't go extreme, I think that it's totally an okay time to be able to do that, because that Leo energy just wants to look like all the good, like I want to show it off, you know what I mean? I want to be regal. I want to be royal. This is what I have to add, right? And that Uranian energy in that Taurus body is shaking some things up. So you can definitely go on a new diet. Just don't start out at the extreme level of that. Ease your way into that, okay? All right, you guys, I think it's going to be a good week. It's definitely a week where, remember, the cosmos are actually working in our favor. Everything that is coming down, everything that we're feeling is a search and is an invitation to engage with astrology, taking us in, not looking for the answers outside of us, but simply responding to the other energies that we can see in our material plane as well. I hope this week is beautiful for you. Like this video, comment, share, subscribe. I love you so much. I look forward to seeing you at the Eat and Greet. I want to hear what you think about the other Eat and Greets as well. So please let me know that either under the Eat and Greet videos or under this video. I look forward to seeing you at the Summit for Passion and Power. And remember, everything can be found in the description box down below. And if you haven't done it yet, please feel free to come on over and check out the Stormy Grace podcast, because it is up, it is going. The episodes are being loaded daily to make sure we've got a good set of content in there, and then we'll start to find a regular flow with that as well. All right, you guys, I love you. I'll see you next week. Bye, everyone.